Joining me now is Sarytogan Graphite Managing Director Sean Gregory to discuss the high performance for lithium-ion batteries made with anodes of Sarytogan's Coated Spherical Purified Graphite, otherwise known as CSPG. Sean, good to see you again.
Good morning, Jonathan.
So, Sean, you've now gone all the way to CSPG. That's a pretty significant step and a milestone in the evolution of the company. Can you talk me through why it is so significant to you?
Yeah, look, Jonathan, you're exactly right. This is a highly significant milestone. It's actually the final piece of the flow sheet that gets us all the way to active anode material. Now, the strategic implication of that is that opens the door to direct relationships with battery manufacturers and auto OEMs. Anything earlier in the value chain puts you at arm's length from those big players in the industry. Many other graphite companies will initially start their operation with some flake graphite production and then gradually expand further down the value chain. The point of difference with Sarytogan is that our giant and exceptionally high-grade mineral resource, we plan to take that all the way through to active anode material in our first development of our project. So it's what we call an integrated flow sheet, where we take it all the way to a multitude of finished products, including the highly prized active anode material.
And Sean, I just want to touch on the OEMs and the battery manufacturers there. I think that's an important point to elaborate on a little bit more. How does it actually open the door for you to build on those direct relationships?
Yeah, well, look, in terms of what a lot of graphite pundits will look at in the marketplace and prices that are actively tracked, there is a product that's actively tracked by a lot of forecasters called uncoated spherical purified graphite. And we certainly plan to make some of that material and presently trades for about US $2,000 per tonne, forecast to move up to $2,500 per tonne. But most of that material goes into China. Some of it goes to South Korea and Japan, but it really puts you at arm's length from the big players in the industry. It goes through those other factories to get it coated and get it into active anode material. And often its provenance is lost through that process. And also the importance of Kazakhstan being a jurisdiction that is, of course, IRA compliant to the US legislation, and also with a significant freight advantage directly to Europe. So what this enables us to do is to cut out the middleman and go directly to those big players. And the pricing, of course, correspondingly jumps up significantly from US $2,500 per tonne up to US $8,000 per tonne. So one, it's a significant value add, an economic value add, but perhaps more importantly, it really positions us in a very strong strategic position in terms of the overall market situation.
Sean, as you mentioned there, it really does give you economic sort of credence to what you're doing and how you're going about doing it. How do you see, especially with the PFS coming up, how do you see the performance of the company given what we've just discussed here?
Yeah, look, I think there's always been people have looked at the Sarytogan project. It's too big, it's too high grade, it's too good to be true. Perhaps this material is only suitable for lead pencils. And time again, we've demonstrated that the offering of this of these products will be far and wide, including some of the most technologically advanced products and the highest priced products in the marketplace. So it really is, in my mind, a unicorn project in terms of low cost, high revenue, highly strategic in terms of its location between Europe and China. And look, I think investors are really hanging out to see that. And the pre-feasibility study will tell the story. That'll actually give us these economics and really give something for investors to hang their hat on. But look, our market cap, we're capped at about $30 million Australian dollars now. Many of our peers with more advanced projects are 10 times that. And, you know, we think there's a real opportunity to climb our way up the league table of graphite companies And the pre-feasibility study, I think, will allow us to grab the right rung on that ladder that we think this project thoroughly deserves. But that's ahead of us, and investors should jump on board now ahead of that news, which, as we've spoken about many times, is on track for completion in September.
So obviously the PFS is to come, but you keep sneaking up on me with extra news. Is there anything else in the pipeline that we should be expecting?
Jonathan, there are a few things in the back pocket as well still to come. There's some more, even though this is, I guess, the pinnacle of battery performance coming to CSPG. We are actually looking at some other product uses, and there'll be some news associated with those as well. And of course, we're always active in the background on the business development front. And we obviously can't say anything, but looking for value wherever we can find it, and bringing that to our shareholders as soon as we can.
Sean, thanks for your time.
My pleasure. Thank you.